Hey guys, welcome to Dark Theory, Inc. This is Rav Theory, and we're going to talk about something that really blows my mind. If you have seen the Gwen Stefani Carpool Karaoke video, you'll know what I'm talking about. At the end where they sing We Are the Champions, and they're all genuinely waiting for that last part. Those last few words that I know, because I'm from that time as well. So I remembered it. I remember sitting there watching this and being totally just as bewildered as they are. And these are people that, like, Gwen Stefani knows music. The gentleman that does the actual Carpool show knows music. And these people are all there. You know, you have George Clooney and Julia Roberts. I'm sure they were around during the time of Queen and that song, and they probably sang it the same way as I did. So this is something to really sit and ponder and think about. As you can see, there's genuine confusion, bewilderment, and they're just like in a different time, in a different place. So you have to realize that something went very wrong at that moment in time, and they can't figure out what it is.
You find computer code writ in the fabric of the cosmos.
We are living in a computer programmed reality, and the only clue we have to it is when some variable is changed and some alteration in our reality occurs.
Strings of bits of ones and zeros. It's not just sort of resembles computer code. You're saying it is computer code.
It's not even just is computer code. It's a special kind of computer code. That's what we find very, very deeply inside the equations that occur in string theory. And it's even more bizarre than that, because when you then try to understand these pictures, you find out that buried in them are computer codes, just like the type that you find in a browser when you go surf the web. And so I'm left with the puzzle of trying to figure out whether I live in the Matrix or not.
And we have to prevent the weaponization of space, because there is a lie being told to everyone. And then he would repeat to me over and over, and the last card, the last card, the last card would be the extraterrestrial threat. He talked about suitcase bombs. He talked about chemical, viral, bacterial, biological warfare that these space-based weapons would never protect us against.
Complete takeover of this planet, the killing off of 5/6 to 7/8 of the world's population. I'll tell you what the alien agenda is.
Besides, some scientists believe that to synthesize a virus requires extraordinary intelligence and workload. So I have never believed that we humans would have the capability at this time to create such a virus.
There is always light by which he can see this event when it comes. See this event. Does that imply that many persons who are somehow asleep or blind or not vigilant, they will not see it even though it occurs? Consider the significance which can be assigned to these notions. The kingdom will come here unexpectedly. This is always stressed. The rightful faithful shall see it, because for them it is always daytime. But for the others, what seems expressed here is the paradoxical but enthralling thought that, and hear this and ponder, the kingdom were it established here would not be visible to those outside it.